When I came to Montana, I was a painter, and I painted since I was in art school. And then at some point, I discovered cardboard, and it was there all along, I just didn't see it. I got this idea in my head to make butterflies out of cardboard, and I was looking at the boxes and thinking, God, they're so colorful, and so I started making life-size cut-out butterflies out of cardboard packaging. Hmm. And eventually, you know, you just get around to doing something else, and this will absolutely be the biggest project I've ever taken on. It took a lot of money and a lot of time, and I had to avoid making a living so that I could spend the time doing this. I mean, it took months and months and months to cut up all the cardboard and get them in the right shape, and then about a month to vacuum them all. Luckily, I had an assistant for that too, a young art student at MSU named Lara Vaenti. She was a big help. She vacuumed them. So I've never actually vacuumed my own toenails. It's the biggest project. I mean, it's just an enormous thing. The numbers are incredible. This whole book is filled with my measurements and then the countdown. I did those drawings. I went over and measured the space exactly and figured out how many tiles I would need and the shapes of all the panels. And then, see, I kept track of the numbers. I actually had 10,000 some cards. And we sorted them into basic 9 basic colors. Mm-hmm. And of course they're all multicolored, but you know, the 9, whatever color hit you first. And I did that because I didn't want to get to the end and have all white ones or all blue ones, and I wanted the colors to be spread out. You know, the major thing for this is figuring out the exact measurements. Mm-hmm. And still I'm not sure, because you have a 14-foot wall that's 46 feet long. You could be an inch off by the time you get to the top. I mean, it could easily vary as it goes up. I assume it doesn't vary too much, but I started working on this model. And it took about 400 hours to build the model and 14,609 tiles. You know, it's an incredible architectural space, I think. For a gallery, it's very unusual. So it's all going to be very, hopefully not intimidating. It's going to be just a little overwhelming when you walk in. Hopefully at the end, if they spend enough time in there, they'll sense this space I want to create, which is meditative.
Ma'am, I'd like to thank the sponsors of the Terry Karson Commons exhibition. The residency, video, and publication are supported through the generosity of the Paul G. Allen Family Foundation. Ma'am, I'd also like to thank the Missoula Independent and Allied Waste, a division of Republic Services, for their support of this exhibition. Thank you. Ma'am, I'd like to thank the sponsors of the Terry Karson Commons exhibition. The residency, video, and publication are supported through the generosity of the Paul G. Allen Family Foundation. Ma'am, I'd also like to thank the Missoula Independent and Allied Waste, a division of Republic Services, for their support of this exhibition.